यस्याभवद्भक्तजनार्ति हन्दुकुपुरुत्तमन्येषु अभिचार्य दूर्णं स्तम्भे वदारस्तमनन्यलभ्यं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये अहोबिले गरुडशैलमध्ये कृपावसत्कल्पितसन्निधानं लक्ष्म्या समालिङ्गितवामबाहं लक्ष्मीनृसिंहं शरणं प्रपद्ये श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहपरब्रह्मणे नमः अस्मद्गुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्सर्वगुरुभ्यो नमः अस्मत्परमगुरुभ्यो नमः श्रीमदे श्री आदिवंशडगोपीरेन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीवंशडगोपश्रीवेदान्तदेशीरेन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीलक्ष्मीनृसिंहदिव्यपादुका सेवक श्रीवंशडगोपश्रीनारायणरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः श्रीमदे श्रीवंशडगोपश्रीरङ्गनाथरीन्द्रमहादेशिकाय नमः ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय जन्मात्यस्य यदोऽन्वयादितरदस्साद्देष्वभिज्ञस्वराट् तेने ब्रह्महृदाय आदिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजोवारिमृदां यदा विनिमयो यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषा धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तगुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि निगमकल्पधरोर्कळिदं फलं शुगमुखादमृतद्रवसंयुधं पिबदभागवतं रसमालयं मुहुरहो रसिका भुवि भावुकाः कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नन्दनाय च नन्दगोपकुमाराय गोविन्दाय नमो नमः नमः पङ्कजनाभाय नमः पङ्कजमालिने नमः पङ्कजनेत्राय नमस्ते पङ्कजाङ्ग्रये வேதத்தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழிமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார் களிற்றை கோலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமயிலை திருவல்லிக்கேனி கண்டேனே ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி वेदान्ताचार्यवर्यो मे सन्निधत्तां सदा हृदि वन्दे बृन्दावनचरं वल्लवीजनवल्लभं जयन्ती सम्भवं धाम वैजयन्ती विभूषणं वसुधेवसुधं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानन्दं कृष्णं वन्दे जगद्गुरुम् त्वं तु सर्वं परित्यज्य स्नेहं स्वजनबन्धुषु मया वेश्य मनस्सम्यक् समदृक् विचरस्वगां यदिदं मनसा वाचा चक्षुर्भ्यां श्रवणादिभिः नश्वरं गृह्यमाणञ्च विद्धि मायामनोमयं पुंसो युक्तस्य नानार्थो भ्रमस गुणदोषभाग् कर्मा कर्म विकर्मेदि गुणदोष धियो बिधा तस्माद् युक्तेन्द्रियग्रामो युक्तचित्त इदं जगत् आत्मनीशस्वविदं आत्मानं मय्यधीश्वरे ज्ञानविज्ञानसंयुक्त आत्मबोधशरीरिणाम् आत्मानुभवदुष्टात्मा नान्तरायैर्विहन्यसे दोषबुद्ध्यो भयादीदो निषधान्न निवर्तते गुणबुद्ध्या च विगिदं न करोति यदर्भगः सर्वभूतसुकृत्शान्तो ज्ञानविज्ञाननिश्चयः पश्यन्मदात्मकं विश्वं न विपद्येद वै पुनः तस्मात् त्वम् उद्धव उत्सृज्य चोदनां प्रतिचोदनां प्रवृत्तिं च निवृत्तिं च श्रोतव्यं श्रुतमेव च माम् एकमेव शरणम् आत्मानं सर्वदेहिनां याहि सर्वात्मभावेन मया स्याह्यगुधो भयः वि आर् एञ्जायिङ्ग् उद्धवगीता टुडे इस् दि 145th सेशन् 11th स्कन्दं 12th अध्यायं वेन् कृष्णा वास् एक्स्प्लैनिङ्ग् Plenty of methodology, plenty of ubhayam, karma, jnana, bhakti, prabhati and all of them. First, Uddhava got worried, that he has to do all of them. Then Krishna explained, no, no, no. Choose one of those things that suits your final reward. Now the question comes to Uddhava. Does he have to do the karma? Can karma give moksham? Can anyone give up this karma, not doing that? Is it necessary to do the karma all the time? What kind of karma we should be doing? So these are the things he's basically asking for, because each Upayam puts the karma as a part of that one, and how much you have to do, what is mandatory, what you can give up, that is what the question basically comes. Simply he's asking, what is the Upayam I have to do? What are all the angas for that one? Mandatory one, optional one. How long you have to do this Upayam? Once the Upayam is done, what about these things? Those are the kind of things he is worried about it. Bhagavan started explaining, karma, when we means that one, it is Prakriti Mandala. So we said in Ragasyatra Saram and Sri Bhashyam and everything, where you draw a lion, that is called Viraja Nadi, Viraja River. Above that one is called Paramapadam, Sri Vaikundam, Nitya Vibhuti. Below that one is the Prakriti Mandalam, that is what the Prabhanjam we are staying and everything. That is one demarcation line, separation line. So anything below that Viraja River is basically Karma Karyam. Bhagavan Srishti is based on the Karma Karyam, not for him. For all the jivans staying here, they have to endure the karma. That is the reason why he is doing the Srishti. So when they are doing the karma, you becoming a karta. Karta means you are doing that one. Once you are a karta, you are also a bhokta into that one also. Because the kartrutyam and bhoktrutvam, both of them are entangled. That is why we get the samsara. So Bhagavan was explaining in the previous slogans, I don't want to repeat all of them. So one, Srishti is done in two different forms. The first form is the sound, Vedas, that is coming at that one. Bhagavan is present in every Vedic syllable. That is the first one. Second one, the manifested products, where you see the rupam of that one, where we have Jnanendriyam, Karmendriyam, Shariram and all other kinds of things we do, that is from the Karana to Sthula to Sukshma to Sthula Rupam. That is one. So this is called Nama Rupa. Remember that one. So first one is a Nama, that is basically the words, Veda. Rupa is the one we are talking about, the manifested products. So, Deshikan in Daya Sadagam says, Avide Visishtan Pralaye Jandun Navalokya Jada Nirvedam Karana Kale Bharayogam Vidarasi Vrishashailanada Karunetvam. Swami Deshikan very beautifully put this one in the 17th sloka. Andal was putting this one, Ambarame Tannire Agaram, in the 17th sloka. Vajabeya Mahayagyam, when you do that one, everything is number 17. 17 is a prime number. Swami wants to show that one, so he put it on the 17th sloka. Just is saying the number here, because Krishna is going to play with the numbers. All the today's sloka, Krishna is going to play with all the numbers and everything. So what it says, Avide Vishishtan Pralaye, Jandun Avalokya Jada Nirveda. So what happens is, during the Pralaya Kalam, all thus us, we don't have any Shariram, we don't have any name. Nama Rubam, nothing is there. And Bhagavan is keeping on his belly button, on his navel, everything, he keeps that one. And he is laying down in the Pralaya Samudram, on the ocean of that pralayam, and for so many different kalpams we don't know. Suddenly Bhagavan thinks, all these chetanas are here, all these chit, the chaitanyam, the sentient things, all our atmas, they cannot do any action. Without shariram, in the Prakriti Mandalam here, but we are below the Viraja river, it cannot do any karyam. So let me give them some sariram so that they can do some karma, they can do punyam and everything, they can do bhakti and prabhati, they can come to the moksham. That is what Bhagavan's intention. That is the reason why he start doing this srishti. So srishti, siddhi, pralayam, like that, continuously he is keep on making all of them. So we were lying down there without nama rubam. That is why I didn't bring that one. So what Krishna is saying first, the Vedam when you say is the nama rubam. And then the second one when he is coming, rubam means basically manifested products, he creates everything from the Prakriti Mandalam. So in the last class we saw the sloka where Krishna was saying, before he was telling Brahmam, Brahmam, and then suddenly he says, I am the one doing all of them. So Krishna wants to see that what you are thinking about all of them, Tati, Tvam, Asi, all of them, Sadeva Swamidam Agrasi, Degameva Dvidiyam, all this word refers only to me. That is what Krishna was saying. Ayam hi jivastravat abhyajo abhyayonihi avyaktaye go vayasa sadhyaham vislishta saktir bagudha iva bhadi bijani yonim pradipatya yatvat. Ayam hi jivastravat abhyayonihi. I am the Supreme Lord. I am the one creates everything. All these jivas are the pralayagalam. Here is the Prakriti, here is the Jeevan, I make all these things. That is what we saw. Prakriti, Magati, Agangaram, Panjatanmatrai, Panjabhudam, Kanjakarmendriyam, Panjanyanendriyam, Manasi. All these 24 tattvams based on that. And putting the Jeevan, 25th tattvam inside, 26th tattvam, I am also going. So, Ayam hi Jeevas, Trivrit, three different gunas, Sattva, Rajasa, Tamasa. Abjayonihi, that is the Tamarapu, already lotus, it is coming. So when out of that one, Trivrit is Muguna Maya, which is we call as a Prakriti Mandalam. Abja is basically is a lotus. Yoni means is the source cause for that one. So Karana Prabhanjam, so it is going to come from that one. What is that one? From the Prakriti. And that Prakriti is my Vasham. I own that. Okay. So I am not dependent on that one. Prakriti is dependent on me. So you have a Prakriti here. Suddha Sattvam Yadi Lila Nitya Vibhuti. And there is a column associated with this. So Avyakta Ego Vayasa Sadhya Avyaktam. I am unmanifested. At that time, nobody can see any of them. So, Ekaha, I am the only one. That is what it says. The Brahman, the Lord, is only one. Vayasasa Adhyaha, I am beyond the time. I am beyond the space. Sarvadesa, Sarvakala, Sarvavastegalam. Vislishta Saktir Bhagudha Ivabhadi. Even though I have divided myself into several different forms, Bhagudha Ivabhadi, in many separated forms, what you see, I am the only one. You see the manifested form of me in different forms, but you cannot see me. At least you cannot see Bhagavan with this naked eyes. We cannot see Bhagavan without jnanam. So how this is one? Bijani yonim pradipatya yatvate. Just like the seed you putting on that one, the tree and everything comes. By looking at the tree, you won't know that one. Such a small seed is bringing all of them. You don't see the seed into that one. Only you see the tree and different parts of the tree. That is what he is saying. All of them is based on the mayai. Mayai means not like Advaitam calls. Mayai illusion, that's not the one. Mayai here means Prakriti. Everything here is based on Prakriti. Only two things are here. Only Prakriti or Atma. That's all we are having here. So, when we say our body is a Prakriti made up of that one, the lamp is made that one, the jalebi is made that one, all of them are only Prakriti. You come from the dust and you go back to the dust. When we say that one, our body is nothing but the dirt. So, now Krishna is going to compare. So far we have seen. So, Krishna slowly coming into how the srishti is made. You got all the Andhakaranam and then 5 Jnanendriyam, 5 Panja Karmendriyam, all those things, this is how he created. I sit inside. You told all of them. Now we listen to that one. Now he is going to compare the Srishti to a tree. The analogy here is going to make Srishti, how he does, is to a tree. Vriksha Kalpana, that is what we call. Kalpana, when we say tree concept, tree hypothesis, tree idea, or tree as a fiction, is trying to imaginary things, try to show you that one. Tree is imagined for Srishti. We bring two ideas over here. What Krishna says, that is what Upanishad also says. Mundaka Upanishad, when we see that one of the Bhagavad Gita class we did that one, Dva Suparna, it talks about two birds and everything. One is the food, the other one watches and everything. We say that one. There, the Jeevan's body, our body is basically compared to a tree. Kadopanishad is there. Atmanam Radhinam Vidhi, we say that. There also, the Srishti is compared to a tree. That is not the body for us. The whole Prabhanjam is a tree. That is what it is compared. So, what Krishna says, these are all concurred by the Upanishads. So, he is not telling anything different. Why are we comparing to a tree? First, before we go into that one, we have to understand why Krishna is saying like this one. First one. Bhagavan is the root of the tree. Even though the root is not visible, we see the tree, branch, leaves, fruits, everything you see. But all of them can be alive, only there is a root. And the root is buried underneath. We don't see that one, we don't observe, we don't realize. That is one first he wants to make. Bhagavan is the basis for all of them. Brahman makes everything, and Brahman, without Brahman, we don't have anything. Second one, the tree, when you see some tree is there, it grows and then it falls off. We see all the kind of things. The nature is basically Nashwaram. All these are called Asaram. See, everything you take, we enjoy the small baby. Nice baby talk and everything, kurandai, maralai and everything. How long are you going to enjoy? After some time, it grows up and goes into a bigger one. You enjoy the office. How long are you going to be there? One day you have to retire and go. See, all these things remains you, all of them. So, we are living in the Alpa Astira Palan. So, the tree goes and falls and everything that remains you, everything is Nashwaram. Everything is here, but they will be gone. So, if it is the Alpa Astira Palan, then what is the final eternal one? If you ask, that is the third one, Moksham. So, the first one, Brahman is the root. Second one, our life in this Prabhanjam, everything is Alpa Astira Palan. Third one, if it is Alpa Astira Palan, you have to get out of this Prabhanjam. See, Moksham, third one. Fourth one, if the moksham is the upayam, moksham is the final reward, what is the ubayam? What is the ubayam for the moksha sadhanam? Is it karma? Is it jnanam? It is bhakti or it's prabhati? That is what you are asking for. Same thing what we had done in the Bhagavad Gita, but in a shrunk fashion. The reason why Krishna is telling, even though we have done prabhati, Uddhava, we think that is like a Prabhanan, but all these things are iterated. So, when Uddhava goes back and teaches all other rishis, you should tell all of them. Second one, people like us, we are all weak souls. After doing all these things, sometimes we may get doubts. So, that is the reason, go back to that one and confirm yourself. Unflinching, Mahavishwasham, we need that one. So, at the end, he is going to tell, after about a 3 or 4 slogans here, Hamsa Upadesam is going to talk. Bhakti Rubena Jnanam. Bhakti Rubena Karma. Bhakti Rubena Bhakti Yogam. Bhakti Rubena Prabhati. Everything what you do has to have intricate of Bhakti. Without Bhakti, you are not going anywhere. That is the reason when we studied Ragasyatra Saram, we say, Karma and Jnana will not give you Moksham. If somebody does the karma, donation and charity, somebody does the yogam, all the pranayama and everything, that will not give you moksham unless you put bhakti into that. That bhakti, sadharana bhakti will not give, Brahma Vidya you have to do. And we see that one, that Brahma Vidya is not possible by us. That is why we opted for the 32nd Nyasa Vidya. So, that bhakti is all different types. Karma Yoga does, there is some bhakti. Jnana Yogam does, different bhakti. Bhakti Yogam does, what bhakti. Prabandhan does bhakti, different bhakti. So, don't get confused with all of them. When each one does one, all other things are also part. Some of them are mandatory, some of them are not. Some of them you do only up to that one and then back off that. So all these things we have to understand correctly because all the yogams are there. So the next one, Krishna is starting. 21st sloka. Yasminidam prodamaseshamodam. Pado yata tantu vidhana samstadaha yayesha samsaras taru puranaha karmatmaga pushpapale prasude. The srishti, what Bhagavan does, is compared to a tree. Here, before that one, he starts. I am in the prabanjam everywhere. He gives an example of a cloth. The cloth is made with the thread. You don't see the thread, but you see the cloth. Even though the cloth, when you say every single corner, there has to be a thread. So that is Bhagavan. So he says, Padho tandu vidhana samstadaha. Padaha. Padaha means basically a cloth. Tantu vidhana. Tantu means thread, nool. Okay. And vidhana means expansion. We also say vidhanam above that one. So that is something expanded, something arranged, something organized. Samsta, it is nicely arranged and presented. It's nicely arranged and assembled and shown off. So padaha, tantu, vidhana samstadaha. How the threads are spread everywhere, assembled nicely and presented in a cloth fashion. They have to be organized correctly. You cannot just put one thread here, one thread there. So that will not bring the cloth. So the machine weaver has to do correctly. How he does that one? Prodam, odam. Prodam means crosswise. Odam means lengthwise. So, in the XY axis, you take the cloth. So, kurukum, nedukum, Tamil solacha. So, lengthwise and widthwise you have to do. All of them very nicely you have to do. So, that is what you just put one string over here, another string, you will not get the cloth. So, pado tandu vidhana samstara prodam odham. So, how the cloth, what you see, is not something new. No, it is not. What you see, you are created actually from the thread. What you are seeing is only the thread, arranged in a nice fashion. It is organized in a nice assembly. So, you need one on the lengthwise, you need the other one on the widthwise, both an XY axis you take, that is how you make the cloth. Double knit, what they call. So, two sides you do the knitting. Though we see the cloth, we don't realize the thread in that one. Most of the time, we see the total product. So, yasmin yadha idam asesham yatha. Just like that one, similarly, likewise, yasmin, in whom? He's saying, idam asesham, this universe. What universe? Asesham, the whole universe, without leaving anything there. Embirumanar took that one. Asesha chidachit vastu seshine seshasayine. So that is the one in the, so Embirumanar is starting the Mangala slogan there. Asesha. Many, many places you would see Asesha in Gadhyam and everything. It says, Krishna is saying, idam asesham. Idam means this world, this prabanjam, this pragrithi mandalam, asesham, without anything leaving. ஸோ லைக் தேசிகன் சேஸ் இந்த பிரதான பிரதிதந்திரம் எவ்ரி திங் தேர் இஸ் நத்திங் இன் தி வேர்ல்ட் தட் டஸ் நாட் பிலாங் டு பகவான் தேர் இஸ் நத்திங் இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட் தட் டஸ் நாட் ஹாவ் பகவான் ப்ரெசன்ட் ஸோ ஈஸ் எவ்ரிவேர் எஸ்மின் யதா இதம் அசேஷம் ஸோ சிமிலர்லி இன் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட் பிரபஞ்சம் நத்திங் இஸ் லெஃப்ட் அவுட் just as the woven cloth completely resting on the manifested projection of the threads that is the presenting to you similarly the entire universe is presented to you residing by the bhagavan inside if the bhagavan is the thread and the cloth what you see is the prapancham so bhagavan is no different than prapancham கடல் ஞாலம் செய்தேனும் ஆவேனே என்றும் கடல் ஞாலம் ஆவேனும் ஐ ஆம் தி சி ஐ ஆம் திஸ் வேர்ல்ட் வென் கிருஷ்ணா சேஸ் லைக் தட் ஒன் நம்மாழ்வார் பிக்ஸ் தட் ஒன் சேயிங் தட் ஓவர் ஹியர் ஸோ திஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் எ பிரபஞ்சம் இஸ் கம்பேர்ட் டு ஏ ட்ரீ ஹவு ஹஸ் மேட் தட் சிருஷ்டி இஸ் நவ் கோயிங் டு கம்பேர்ட் டு ஏ ட்ரீ ய ஏஷ சம்சார தருஹு in which this prabanjam what we see eshaha this one samsara mean birth death cycle karma sambandham associated with the material world associated with the prakriti mandalam that is what we call samsaram taruhu taru means a vriksham tree so this prabanjam is compared to the vriksham சம்சாரம் இஸ் லைக் எ ட்ரீ ஆல் திஸ் பிரபஞ்சம் கிரியேஷன் எவ்ரி திங் வாட் யூ மேக் வி ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் ஹவு ஓல்ட் இஸ் திஸ் ஒன் ஜஸ்ட் லைக் எ ட்ரீ வி ஆர் ஆஸ்கிங் ஹவு ஓல்ட் இஸ் திஸ் ட்ரீ ஸோ வென் யூ கோ டு தி ரெட் வுட் ஃபாரஸ்ட் தே சே தி ட்ரீஸ் ஆஃப் தம் ஓல்டர் தேன் பிஃபோர் ஜீசஸ் கிரைஸ்ட் ஆல் அவர் நம்பர்ஸ் ஆர் பேஸ்ட் ஆன் 2020 AD So, even before that, that means more than 2,000 years old. So, we are asking, how old is that? Similarly, if you are comparing to a tree, how old is a samsaram? Samsaram is anadi. So, there is one person asks a question there. How come the muktas and nityas don't have any karma? What did they do? So, we'll pick it up in the lab session. So, want to say, we are in the samsaram anadi. Anadi means there is no beginning, beginningless. So, sa esha, ya esha samsara taru, when you say that one, that samsaram, beginningless, puranaha karmatmagaha, puranaha, old one, antique, ancient. Karmaha means it is always connected with the action and the reward. That is what karma. Karma, karma palan. Atmaha, karma nature. That is what it says. Karma, atmaha. Karma nature. So, karma nature means it is basically pravritti as the swabhavam. This prabanjam is pravritti as a swabhavam. When can you give up that karma? You are asking. So, if it is a pravritti sambandham, samsaram basically action and palan. Action, palan. This is cyclical. That is why we said ajnanam, karma, vasane, ruji, dega sambandham, vicious circle over there. That continuously you do, continuously it gives you palan, then you do. It never ends like that one. So, this prabanjam is basically karma. This prabanjam is basically samsaram and it is so ancient anadi so that is what it says ya esha samsara taru purana karmaatmagaha so this prabanjam is so old karma based pushpapale prasude pushpapale pushpam everybody knows is a flower what the tree will give First, it will give you a nice small flower. Pale means basically fruit it's going to give. So, the flowers ripen and mature into the fruit. Prasude produced. The tree will produce pushpam and palam. Whenever you see a tree or some kind of a plant, they are asking that one. Whenever we see that one, they are asking a question. Oh, nice plant. What flower it will give? Or when you see a tree, what fruit it will give? So we always interested in the pushpam and the palam, what it will give. So is a samsaram, is a vriksham like that one, what it's going to give? It's going to give suga dukkham, happiness and despair. So Krishna did not tell explicitly like that. It is so obvious. You can understand that one. Karma will give you enjoyment and distress, sugam and dukkham. So that is one way you can take. Or pushpa pala, if you take it, if the pushpam from that one fruit is coming, if the pushpam is action, fruit is basically the reward of that. So that is also you can take. So before a tree to blossom, it has to appear, and what you have to have the root, and the root you don't see, similar to the thread, what in a cloth you don't see, Bhagavan is there, and that is how the vriksham is coming, and it is giving the two fruits, the flowers and the fruits. See, two things it gives, that is basically karma palan, punya pavam, sugar dukkam. So that is how it is all associated. So in the sloka here, very easy one. Yasmin idam prodam asesha modam pado yatha tantu vidana samstaha ayesha samsaras taru puranaha karmatmaga pushpapale prasude. So that is what Krishna was saying over here. The concept of the tree is going to expand in the next two slogas. Let's pick the first sloga. Dve asya bije shatamulas trinalaham panjas gandaha panjarasa prasudihi dashaiga shakodvi subarna nidaha trivalkalo dvipalorgam pravishtaha. Dve asyaha bije shadamula trinalaha panjas gandaha panjarasa prasudihi. That is the first part. Asya, of this tree, what I've been telling you, the tree is basically samsaram. First, for the tree to come, we need a seed. Without a seed, there is no tree. But all the tree we know of, there's only one seed. You put that seed, the tree comes from that one. So, but for samsaram, there are two seeds, Krishna is telling. For samsaram, there is two seeds. Krishna did not elaborate here also. The answer is obvious. That is the punyam and pavam. Because of the seed, the samsara tree is going to come. And he says, what is that tree? Your shariram, your buddhi, your manasu, your DBJ. All these things you're going to get based on your punya pavam, what we call as the karma. What you sow, that is what you're going to reap. What you throw, it's like a boomerang come back to you. If someone has got all of them punyam, no pavam at all, then you would be sitting as a Brahma, or Indra, or Deva. If someone has got all the pavam, he may be a Rakshasa or Asura like that one. We has got some punyam, some pavam. That is the reason why we are human being. We are in this mandalam. So punya pavam is mixed for us. That is the first thing we have to understand. So there are two seeds are there. The two seeds coming into over here, punyam and pavam, that makes it tree. Shatamulaham. It has got 100 roots. The root is the one holding all of them. There is a wind, there's a hurricane, there's a rain. Without that one falling, it is standing over there. Hundreds of small roots are there in the tree. Otherwise, it will fall. So, we are standing. That means we are living. Not actually, we shouldn't say standing.
We are all running, chasing the entire thing. But here it just says standing. Okay. Shadamulaga. So many different things that is going to hold you into that one. That is basically the seed expanded into the all these roots, and that roots is going to get you into that one. Trinalaham. Three of the lower trunks. Whenever you see a huge tree coming up, you will see three trunks would be there. In most of the trees, the three big branches are there. They emerge from the main one. They will be in all different direction to balance. Nature does all of them. One goes one way, the other one. So the tree can stand totally. So from that one, small branches and everything is going to come. So Karana, Stula, Sukshma, Shariram. We are basically talking. So the seed is basically Pavam and Punyam. And then we said hundreds of roots. What is that root? Your desire. Whatever we wish. Our Mogam. Our Ashai. So that is the roots of all of them. So three branches are there. That is basically your Shariram is started making that one. So the growth is nicely divided and it is given everywhere. So the Shariram, when it goes three branches and it goes all of them, very nicely the water and the fertilizer you put over there, it goes into the correct place. See, in our body also, we eat all the food and everything. All the food does not go into our nose. All the food does not go into our ear. Ear becomes big. Maybe you can say most of the food goes into the stomach. That is why you have the belly. So what we are saying, very nicely Bhagavan has made, it's went and distributed in all the places. So similarly, our Punyam and Pavam, what we are doing, based on the desires that is holding, going into all different places. That is why somebody is having a good hearing. Somebody cannot see correctly. So the food goes into different places depending upon your Punyam and Pavam. That is what Krishna is saying. Next one. Panjaskan Gandaha. Five upper small trunks. After the three, there are five of them there. What is that one? Panjabhudam. So the Panjabhudam we have to use. From that, our Shariram is basically made of that one. So that is what Panjabhudam. Panjarasaha. Panjarasaha Prasudi. Five different kinds of rasam here means sap. So when you are having a maple tree, you go into the sap, you hit on that one and take the maple syrup from that one, rasam. So here the sap, that's what sap, the sugadukkam is going to come from the five jnana indriyams. So panja rasa, when you say, I have five different kinds of jnanendriyam, knowledge senses, that is giving input to me. So from that one, I am going to enjoy all of them. Panja rasa prasudihi. Not five different kinds of rasam. What it means? This panja indriyam produces this kind of a different kinds of your taste and everything. Dasha ega shako. Dasha ega Shake. So, Dasa, Patthu, Eka, 1, 11. 11 branches are there. What is that 11 branches? 5 Jnanendriyam, 5 Karmendriyam, 1 Manasu, 11. Panja Rasa Prasudi, you told before, na, that is not Jnanendriyam. That is the Anubhavam what we are going to get from the Jnanendriyam. Now, the Jnanendriyam and Karmendriyam and Manasu put together, all your Indriyam, 11, Dasha ega shako, dasha ega saga. So, when you have a tree, these are the things you see. And that is how our tree is basically made, our body. Then, whenever you see a tree, there would be a bird sitting there. Maybe invariably one or many birds. Dvi subarna nidha. Dvi, two. Subarna, basically birds. Nidha, nidha means a nest. Spot, resting place, a place for settling something, residence, that is called nida. So, there are two birds are there, they making a nest in this body. two beautiful birds, I made a nest in this tree. You can assume anything. Krishna did not elaborate. The two birds, you can think one bird is a Jivan, the other bird is a Ishwaran. One Upanishad says like that. Or you can assume these are two Jivans. One Jivan is a Baddha Jivan, the other one is a Mukta Jivan. Another one says like that. We can assume any of them and we can find all the different kind of a comparison in all of them. So, Tri Valkalo Dvibalorgam Pravishtam. Tri Valkalaha. Three types of bark. Bark is the one, see, when we are wearing, there will be a jacket, there will be a shirt, and there's a t-shirt inside, similar to that one. So, if you keep on removing the external things, layers out of that one, you see the bark over here. Very good example is, Tamil Sona Vaalathandu. So, you remove one by one in the plantain, the whatever the trunk, so you will see something in. And if you keep on going inside, what it would be, it's like a cabbage or onion. You keep on opening inside, what do you see? Nothing. Nothing would be there. So that is what he wants to point out here. Tri Valkalo Valkala. Valkala means bark. Okay, three different types of them are there. What is that one? Kaba Vada Pittai. That is one controlling your body. Tvi Balaha. Two fruits are there. What is the two fruits over there? Sugam and Dukkam. Happiness and despair. So that is what? Pravishta Argam. This tree, how tall is this tree? If you are asking, Krishna is smiling and saying, this tree goes all the way to the Brahmalogam. Pravishta Argam, it is extending all the way to the Suryan. That is what it says. What it means is Brahmalogam. What Krishna wants to say over here, when we say samsaram, everybody in the Prakriti Mandalam is a samsari. Just like you and me, Deva samsaris, Asuras samsari, Shiva is samsari, Brahma is samsari. What is samsari? They are bounded by the karma. They are not caste. They are basically manifested product. They are all not karyam. They are not karanam. Very beautifully it tells how this whole srishti has made it comparing to your body. Pravishtargam, it goes all the way. So, all the logams, we say 14 logams, all of them samsaram only. Okay? So, two birds is a saying, samsari, asamsari. How can there's asamsari when you say this Prakriti Mandalam na? Those who are having the boarding pass. Okay? You are, just like they say, president-elect. Today, you are Mukta elect. You are not a Mukta yet. When you say Muktan means a trivial case when you go to the Moksham. So there is no difference between Muktan and Nityan. So when we say Mukta means here, Prabannan, who has got the boarding pass, is just waiting for the remaining days. So you are already president elect, Mukta elect. So the two birds introduced here, Baddha Jeevan and Mukta Jeevan. So, Mundaka Upanishad also seems the same idea. That is what we are taking here. Going into the next sloka. Adanti chaikam palamasya gridhra grame charayega maranya vasaham amsaya yegam bhagurubha mijyaihi maya mayam veda saveda vedam. Beautiful. Krishna was saying, very nice sloka. Two birds are residing on the tree. In this sloka, more information is given. I have described about the tree. Now I tell you about the birds. So in this sloka, more information about the birds. First bird is a vulture. Second bird is a hamsam. Hamsam is very special case. Because we have seen in many places, it's a legendary. I don't think we can see anything. Hamsam, what it would do, if you put water and milk together, it can take only the milk. Water would stay there. It has got the power to separate and take the milk. Paramahamsa Parivrajakacharya, when we say for acharyas and everything, Paramahamsa, even for Ramakrishna, Paramahamsa. Paramahamsa means those people, when you see all the worldly things mixed with the Bhagavan and everything, they can extract only Bhagavat Vishayam. All others, they'll leave that one. So that is what is called Hamsam. So it's a legendary one. You cannot ask where it is right now or anything. So Vulture Grame Chara, he said that. Vulture is in the Gramam. Second bird, Hamsa, Aranyavasaha. Aranyavasaha means it's going to be in the forest. So that is what he is going to describe here. Cha Asya Adhanti. Cha, and also whatever I told about the tree, Asya and the tree, Adanti, they eat and enjoy. Who eats what and how they enjoy? Next one you ask, Egam palam gridra grame, gramechara, gramechara. Egam palam gridra gramecharaha. That is what. Egam palam. One fruit is going to eat. Gridra, Gridra, Jadidakta, Daksham, Raguviragadhyam, Gridra, Jadayu, Vulture. So, those who are lusty, those people who have mogam, those people who are talking about me and mine, when they are talking about that one, they are nothing but vulture. That's what it says. Gramechara. What they would do? Gramechara means they're living and moving around inside the villages. That means is not ekantam. They will be with the people. With the people, not only the tum tu sarvam parityachya snegam swajana bandushu. Why Krishna said like that? I don't have anybody. I am all alone. Now, if you are sitting amongst the things, that is going to be the bogyam for you. That is the same thing. That is the reason Krishna first said that one. Tum tu sarvam parityachya. Material ase. First give up that one. Then only people. Okay. First you have to give up all this material. Now giving up the people is going to be very difficult. So even Vyasa Bhagavan, when Shuga Brahmam is going, hey son, he went there. He left all of them. Still people leaving. Is the last one. Tumta sarvam parityachya snegam sojana bandushu. Bandhu is the last one you're going to give up. It is not that easy to give up on your spouse, on your children, or your grandchildren, or your friends, none of them. That is why Krishna put that one at the last. Giving up means what? Giving up means you will be talking to them, you will be doing everything, but don't expect anything from them. Whether they do a good thing one day or whether they do a bad thing to you the next day, samadrak, you need that. That is what Krishna was saying. So, grame charaha, they are like a vulture moving around in the village. And they will be eating one fruit. And that fruit is called samsaram. And that samsaram, they will be eating the mogam and mayakam and all those kinds of things that is going to be pravritti sambandham. More and more it's going to generate. It is going to be recursive going into that one. So, one who engages in the karma margam, a Uddhava, you asked, what kind of a karma I should do? You asked that one. Now I am telling you, don't be like a vulture. That means, nishiddha karma, kamya karma, there is no necessity for you. So that is why, don't be like a vulture, don't start enjoying samsaram. Samsaram in you enjoy, kollendre kalandarinde selvam neruppaga, Alvar says, take me the wealth without asking, it will come to you. I put $10, today is $1,000, next is, yes, of course, all of them are nothing but a fire, is going to put fire on you. That is what Alvar says. So, don't go into nishiddha karma, kamya karma. That's nothing is needed. We have done the last kamya karma. Last kamya karma is our prabhatti. Prabhatti is not a nitya karma or naimitya karma. We have done. Mukur Arya Singer used to say, that's it. You got everything. You don't need anything else.
Ekam aranyavasaha hamsaha.
Ekam, another.
Aranya, aranya, aranya.
You see, forest.
Vasaha, those who live.
Very beautiful. Krishna's word here. Aranyam, don't think that is basically forest. Aranyam means Veda. Aranya Gandam, when you start that one, look at that one, Rama says, so Aranyam means basically Vedas. They live in the Vedas. What is Veda? Bhagavan. Vedas is the proof of the Bhagavan. So, all the Nitya, Naimitya, Karma, everything what it says, and Varnashrama Dharmam, based on that Veda, they live like that. Their vasam is based on Veda. Very beautiful, Krishna was saying here. He enjoys the moksha sugam. So if you are doing the prabhatti, if you are becoming the prabhannan and you are becoming the mukta jivan elect, you can prabhattik anantarame moksham. He is enjoying that one. Like Janaka Maharaja was sitting, all the palaces on fire, he does not care. Similarly, you don't have to care. You have the boarding pass. What happens to the city? What happens to the Starbucks store? What happens to the bookstore? You don't really care. None of them bothers you. None of them is entangling you. All you have to see how you go into the tube, go into the plane and take off. So, how you go into the Archiradi Margam, Parivuna Brahmana Bhavam, are we going to get? That's all you have to think about it. So, very nicely, Egam aranyavasaha hamsaha. They are like the hamsam. You have to be like a hamsam. What do you have to do? All the worldly things ignore. And all the time worldly things and Bhagavan is always mixed. Even satsangam when we go, they talk for 2 hours about Perumal and everything, sloga, at the end. Then everybody start eating and talking about all other things. You have to get away from that. That is where you have to be the hamsam. So, where you have to have a satsangam, where you have to have ekantam, it is your discretion. So, that is how Krishna is saying here.
Maya mayam bahurubam yegam manomayam.
We saw 4 or 5 slogans back. You cannot see me. How can you see that one? Through your mind. Darsana samanagaram. We don't have to worry about it. We can see the Perumal picture, that's good enough. We don't have to do darsana samanagaram. Bhakti yogi has to do. If you do that one, it is good. Only that is a palan. If you don't do, there's no problem. So, maya mayam, manomayam, maya mayam. First sloga, first 6 slogas we saw that one. Here he is saying, maya mayam, I am producing everything. I am the mayai. I am the one, all the superlative things I will do. Astounding things. Bahurubam, I do in so many different forms. Ekam, I am the only one. Brahma Tattvam is only one. Brahmam is only one. But it manifests into several things. Just like you have the tree like that one. Like how the cloth, all the thread is going everywhere. I am everywhere. Very beautifully he says, mayamayam bahurubam egam. So the Paramatma is only one.
Ijjaha yaveda.
Ijjaha. Ijjai. When we say that one, Panjagala Prakriya, Swami Desikan was telling 5 different periods of the day you divide. Abhigamanam, Ubadanam, Ijja, Swadhyayam, Yogam. You do that one. Ijja is what? Bhagavat Aradhanam. How do you do the Bhagavat Aradhanam? Bhagavat Aradhanam, your Acharya, some guru has to teach. And on the Bhagavat Aradhanam, what do? You say Acharya Thaniyan. What do? Ragasyam you say. And you pray for the Acharya. He has done everything for you. Samashranam, that is why you do this one. He has done Baranyasam, you're going to go to the Moksham. That is why Ijja, what it means here, not Aradhanam. Ijja means basically you are worshipable, you are Acharya. You are enjoying the Acharya, You are telling Isthanian, you are doing, that is what Ijya here it means. The teacher, the reference to the teacher, worshipped through Acharya. This Bhagavan, I do the Tiruvaradhanam through Acharya. Only he has given you that license, Panjasamskaram. With that only we are doing. Only he has given that boarding pass. With that only we are carefree. Nishamshayaga, Shugamashwa and everything. So, Ijaya, one who worships the Acharya and through which he is doing the Bhagavat Aradhanam, so far he was telling Satsangam. Now, how do you go to the Bhagavan? Only through Acharya. Beautiful. Ijaya Veda, the one who understands this one, only through Acharya we can go closer to Bhagavan. Why the Acharya is very important here? Krishna, why is... See, Satsangam, you are gone. But why specifically one small thing he puts some tying knot over here. Why he says that? Satsangam, we might have heard so many things. That so many things, each one gives their own experience. So when you come back to your home, you may be... Oh, maybe I should do this, maybe I should not do that. You will have a lot of confusion would be there. Okay? Some people will, some people may not. So whatever the knowledge you have already acquired, that has to be rammed. The only way you can ram that one is Acharya Bhakti. Next sloka is going to say that one. Only through Acharya Bhakti, I have done moksha sadhanam, moksha ubayam, visesham, I have done that one. Bhagavan will definitely give me. So, the more and more and more you think of Acharya, the faith, the Mahavishwasam comes. Only with Mahavishwasam, then you're going to do Aradhanam. Very nicely. Ijyaha ya Veda. So, finally he says that one, Sa Veda Vedam. Such a person, Sa Veda knows Vedam. He knows Vedas. So, what is the essence of the Vedas? The essence of the Vedas, go to the Satsangam, learn everything, go through the Acharya, his blessings, do the Tiruvaradhanam, that is the essence of Vedas. Nothing else. And that is what you are doing. Where did you learn the knowledge of Prabhatti? Only through Satsangam. And then you got one day opportunity, go to the Acharya. He did the Baranyasam and he did the Panjasamskaram for you first. And then with that one you come to the Tiruvaradhanam. So when you stand before the Bhagavan, you have a very nice recommendation letter and you are having a bhavyam over there, like a Dvayamantram, Arthanusandhanena. You standing there and you say thanks to, worship, respect, reverence to your Acharya through which you do. So, that is where you start. You always start with your Acharya, do all of them. So, Sa Veda Vedam, you have to go backwards. Who is the person who understands all the Vedam? Only the one who does the Bhagavat Tiruvaradhanam. How you do the Bhagavat Tiruvaradhanam? Acharya teaches that one. Acharya makes you eligible for that. How do you go to the Acharya? Through Satsangam. How do you go to the Satsangam? Only through Bhakti. That is how he brings all of them very nicely. Veda Vedyan, who is the Veda Vedyan? Abdina, the one who always thinking about Acharya and he does it to the Bhagavan. So all the tattvams of the Veda, what he is trying to tell, go and surrender to your Acharya. That is what he is saying over here. So next one, 24th sloka, that is the last sloka. Evam guru pasana yaiga bhaktya vidya kutarena shidhena dhiraha vivruschya jivashayam apramattaha sambhatya cha atmana madatya jastram. Looks a little tough but a easy slogan. Evam, we have to transpose the words. Evam Dhiraha apramattaha evam das. Hey Uddhava, you are listening to me so far, what I have told. The knowledge, the jnanam, what you got. Forget about all of them. Last 5 slogans I told you, you got that one. Forget about that one. Last sloga I told you, that is good enough. If you go to the Acharya, you don't need any knowledge. Bhagavan does not want any jnanam. The only jnanam he wants you to go to the Acharya, your Acharya will do everything for you. We saw in the Kuratharvana, there was one person who cannot talk, who cannot hear. And he went inside, asked Bhagavad Ramanuja, I want Sharanagadi. So he was writing and showing. Emperor hugged him and he did the Sharanagadi. Kuratharvan watching that one, oh, what a bhavi I am. I got my eyesight, I got my vaku, I got my ear, hearing. If I didn't have, I had the Acharya's person. I would have had Acharya directly doing to me. What a bhavi I am, that's what he was feeling. So, you don't need any of them. The only qualification what you need for prabhatti is to understand you are unqualified in everything else. That is so easy. Aginchanyam. Karpanya. Karpanyam is aginchanya anusandhanam. So you have to do. Acharya, go and stand there. You will do it for that. You got everything. You don't need all Swami Desiga, all Ramanuja, all your Acharya. Where the place they go, that's the place you also go. Jnanam is not a prerequisite. Jnanam is not a eligibility for prabhatti. The eligibility for prabhatti is Acharya Kadaksham. That is what we saw in the first Ubodgadam. All the 6 things we say, is all of them, that takes you to Acharya, and Acharya gives you the moksham for you. He gives the boarding pass and everything. So, evam dhiraha. Hey, thus you got the knowledge, Uddhava, Jnanam, Upadesham I gave you, Dhiraha, you have a steady knowledge, Anam, Jnanam. The Jnanam you got, what Jnanam you got? Go to the Acharya, that Jnanam you got. So, and you got this Ubayam. What is Ubayam? Prabhati is the only one I need. Uddhava, you are a Buddhiman, you are smart, and you are very shrewd, and you got this one right now. Evam Dhiraha. Immediately Krishna said, Apramatta. However smart you are, however shrewd you are, you will get confused sometime. Don't ever get confused. Krishna very beautifully says, even Dhiraha, even you got direct Upadesham from me, the samsaram is like that one. This Prakriti Mandalam always tried to do bad things for you. You have to get away from that one. So you act accordingly without any unsteadiness, unsteadier or unflinching. So you should not be flinching. You should not be unsteady. So come and straight. That is why when you say, Tumta sarvam parityacha snegam swajana bandushu mayi avesya mana samyak. Krishna is saying, how do you go to the Perumal? How do you go to this Ubayam is good? Because of the Acharya. Acharya Kadaksham is there. He said, you are going moksham. That's all I need. I don't need anything else. Unflinching you need. So that is, he is bringing the explanation for that. And what you do, Abdin Geta, first you don't need me. You need your Acharya. Krishna is saying that one. Guru Pasanayaiga Bhaktya. Guru Upasanaya. Guru Upasanaya. Guru means your Acharya. Upasanaya means homage paying, worshipping, adoration, service, kaingaryam. No, not that one. Those are lower level terms. Here, Krishna is comparing, bhakti is called Upasana. Vedanam, Dhyanam. Same way what Bhakti Yogi does, that Upasana, you do Guru Upasana here. Very beautifully said. Prabhannan, you don't have to do anything. Sarvagalamam Dhyanam of your Bhagavan only. That Bhagavan who showed you Acharya. So, Dhyanam of that Acharya is good enough. I am inside there. So, all the time, like the Bhakti Yogi who does the Upasana, you do the ಗುರು ಉಪಾಸನ, ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಉಪಾಸನ, ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್. ಏಕಭಕ್ತಿಯ, ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬ್ರಿಂಗ್ ಮೀ ಇನ್ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಏಕಭಕ್ತಿಯ ಅನ್ಡೈಲ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಅನ್ಅಲಾಯ್ಡ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ. ಐ ಲವ್ 10 ಆಚಾರ್ಯಸ್, ಐ ಲವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್, ಐ ಲವ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗಾಡ್, ಐ ಲವ್ ದಿಸ್, ನನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಮ್ ಈಸ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್. ಯುವರ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಗೇವ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್, ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ನೀಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ. ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್, ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಫೈನಲಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಭಕ್ತಿ, ಅನ್ಡೈಲ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಭಕ್ತಿ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಡೂ ದಟ್ ಒನ್, ವಾಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್? ನೌ ಯು ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಕ್ಷತ್ರಿಯ. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ? ಶಿಧೇನ ಕುಠಾರೇಣ ವಿದ್ಯಾ, ಶಿಧೇನ ಶಾರ್ಪ್, ಓಕೆ, ಕುಠಾರೇಣ ಆಕ್ಸ್, ಯು ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಎ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಆಕ್ಸ್? ಗೆಟ್ ವಿದ್ಯಾ, ಜ್ಞಾನಂ. ಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್. ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಆರ್ಡಿನರಿ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಎ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್. ಬಟ್ ಐ ವೆಂಟ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ, ಓನ್ಲಿ ವೆರಿ ಫ್ಯೂ ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಎನಫ್. ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಡನ್ ಪ್ರಭತಿ ಫಾರ್ ಯು, ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಡ್ ಯು, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಯು ನೀಡ್. ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸ್ಲೆಸ್. ದಿ ಶಾರ್ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಂ ಯು ನೀಡ್, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್ ಪ್ರಭತಿ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಸದಾಚಾರ್ಯ, ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಮೋಕ್ಷಂ, ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಡ್ ಮೀ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್, ಶಾರ್ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್. ಶಿತೇನ ಕುಡಾರೇಣ ವಿದ್ಯಾ, ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಆಕ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್? ನಾಲೆಡ್ಜ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್? ಸಿ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಇನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಯೋಗಂ, ದೆನ್ ದೇ ವುಡ್ ಸೇ, ಓ ದೇರ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಟು ಧ್ಯಾನಂ, ಮನನಂ, ನಿಧಿಧ್ಯಾಸನಂ, ಆಲ್ ನನ್ ಅಥಮ್ ಇಸ್ ನೀಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು. ಸೋಂಬರೈ ಉಗತ್ತಿ ಪೋಲುಂ, ಗೋ ಟು ದಿ ಕಾರ್ನರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರೂಮ್, ಸಿಟ್ ದೇರ್. ಮೈ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ಡ್ ಮೀ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಮೋಕ್ಷಂ, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎನಿ ಗುಡ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎನಿ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್, ಐಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಎ ಜಡಂ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಎನಫ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದಿ ಮೋಕ್ಷಂ. ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೂ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ದಿ ಪನಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ. ಸೊ ಆಲ್ ಯಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅನ್ಫ್ಲಿಂಚಿಂಗ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ. ದಟ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ಅಂಗ್ರದು ಉಪಾಸನಂ. ಸೊ ಯುವರ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ತನಿ, ಅಂಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಆನ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್, ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಶುಡ್ ಐ ಸೇ ಅಷ್ಟಾಕ್ಷರಂ, ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ ದ್ವಯಂ, ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಚರಮ ಶ್ಲೋಕಂ, ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಆಸ್ಕ್. ನೋಬಡಿ ಆಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ತನಿಯನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಸೇಸ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ರಹಸ್ಯಂ. ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಆಚಾರ್ಯ ತನಿಯನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ದೇರ್. ಓಕೆ. ವಿವೃಶ್ಚ್ಯ ಜೀವಾಶಯಂ, ವಿವೃಶ್ಚ್ಯ, ವಿವೃಶ್ಯ ಮೀನ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್. You are like a kshatriya, in the sense you are taking the axe, but you are in a different varnas, and here we don't need any blood. We have to remove this body. Jeevashayam, jeevashayam. The living body what you are having is made up of prakriti, and that has to be completely gone. Aprakrdam you need. So this has to be removed. How it will be removed? You take the sharp axe and cut it out. What is the sharp axe that's going to cut it out? Baranyasam. Okay. So you are a Sharanagari. What you do, that is going to remove all of them. So here, once you have done, you are giving up. Abdina, giving up is going to be not a tamasa or a rajasa. Tyagam has to be Satvika Tyagam. See, two kids are fighting for one toy, and then the kid does not get that, okay, take it. That is not a sacrifice, okay? That is a desperation. So, when we do Tumta Sarvam Parityache, you know, what is the point? I've been suffering for until 8 years old, wife is not listening, husband is not listening, son is not listening. Then I give up everything. No, no, no. Sanyasam is not because they are not listening. Sanyasam is because they are listening. They are all listening. Everything is nice. But you understand Nashwaram. That is what you have to do. Okay? So when you do, what would happen? Sambhatya Atmanam Cha Adha Tyaja Astram. Sambhatya. You're going to get that Sampath. Somebody is basically achieving, attaining, gaining, rewarding. You're going to get all of them. Atmanam, you're going to get that Atma. What is that Atma? Paramatma. You're going to get the Bhagavan. So you're going to get that. Cha, and also, this is very important. Ada, Tyaja, Astram. Once you get the Paramatma, give up. Give up what? Tyaja, give up. Astram, the Astram. Sharanagadi, you do only once. Like a Brahmastram. Then give up that one. You don't need any more. Once you do, you got it. So, here, Sambhatya Atmanam, when it says, Bhagavan's Paramatma, you're going to get moksham, you're going to be the part of that. Agam Brahmasmi, I am a part of you and I cannot be separated from you. All these things you're going to say, Kosi, when Bhagavan asks in the moksham. That is what you are preparing all of them. You are part of him, you cannot be separated on all of them. So when you say, Atmanam, I understand what is my Atma. I understand what is Paramatma. I understand I am the Shariram. I understand he is the Sariri. That knowledge is going to come through basically. You don't need any of them. Acharya did the Pashanagadi. He says, don't worry. You just go and live. You'll go to the moksha. So just to keep on repeating Acharya Athanian, that is good enough. The jnanam what you need, the only jnanam you need, I have to do prabhati to get out of this samsaram. Okay. So now, once you have done ata, ata when he says that, that's very important. Then, tyaja astram. Krishna, there you said, take the axe. Here you said astram. Look at that. What he means here, brahmastram. The brahmastram, Mari, that is what Deshian uses in Ragasatra Saram, Sharanagati. Just leave it. Only once you can do prayogam. You leave that one and you never have to worry anything. So this is almost like you go to the airport and you dump your luggage. You give your ticket and then they give the boarding pass. Once you give the boarding pass, you go and sit in the boarding lounge. Then they're asking, where is my ticket now? You don't have your ticket, sir. That is gone. You have used once. It's gone. That is where you got the boarding pass. You use your Sharanagati. It is gone. You don't need any more. You got the boarding pass. You are going to go. That is why Krishna very beautifully said at the end of this chapter, Cha, after doing all of them, Ada, Tyaja, Astram. The most important, we stress what would deny your moksha. We said two things, Bhagavad-abhacharam, Bhagavad-abhacharam. No, there is a third one. The third one is, you cannot do any other ubhayam or the same ubhayam second time for moksha. That's the third one. So Krishna insert that one. So that is the reason why Deshika also says that one. It is like a Brahmastram. So now you remember from Krishna's word, once you have used that Ubayam, Tyaja, I don't need any more. Forget about Anga Angi. That is the reason why people are asking Anugulya Sangalpam, Pradyulya Varjanam, Karpanyam, Bhagavishwasham, Gopturtam. You say all of them and that guy after Prabhati is going to knocking down Perumal Kovil. That's okay. Tyaja, he has given up that. If he does that one, he is going to get pavam and he is going to go through that. His karma is making like that. So never at that moment, uyum are enni, it is gone. Tyaja, that nanosecond it falls off. You don't need any more. Krishna very beautifully says, don't do it again. And then don't look at any other ubhayam for the same thing. You are all done. Cha, adaha, tyaja, astram. Very beautifully says that one. Your boarding pass is good enough. You don't need anything else. So that will complete Idi Srimad Bhagavade Mahapurane Ekadasa Skande Dvadasodhyayaha Shampurnam. Thus, the end of 11th canto, 12th chapter of Srimad Bhagavade Mahapurane. Purana. So, just to tell where we are, We started in Bhagavata Mahapurana, 11th Skandam, 7th chapter. 11-7 all the way to 11-29. There are 24 adhyayams are there. If you are taking Uddhava Gita, we are in the 7th one. Out of 24, we have done 7 completed. That is 311 slogas we have completed. How much is the total Uddhava Gita? If you add all of them, Krishna, what do you will put? 1080. 108, another 0. So, that number of slogas are there in Uddhava Gita. So, we have done 311. This chapter what we take, we enjoy that one because Nammalvar follows the same thing. When you are doing advice, don't do it big. Everything in 2 lines. This is the shortest chapter. All other chapters, when you look, 35 slogas, 55 slogas, 60 slogas, here is only 24. When you do the 24 tattvams you have to master, so 25th tattvam of Jeevan understands the 26th tattvam of Bhagavan. All of them, when Krishna says, Deshika plays with the number, Deshika learns everything from Krishna. He plays with the numbers also. So many of them are there. We are scratching all of them. So, we'll conclude this chapter. Next chapter is going to ask, okay, I told you all of them, samsara, vriksham and everything, punyam and pavam and everything. So, Uddhava is confused. I'm always scared. Pavam will come to me and everything. What karma I should be doing? So, Krishna is going to tell, sattva-gunam. Sattva-gunam is more important. To do sattva-gunam, to get sattva-gunam, you make the environment sattvam. Okay? So, all the scary kinds of things, all the crazy food and everything, all the crazy people and everything, don't go into that. That will create rajo and tamo gunam and everything. So, you have to have a sattva gunam. That is why slowly come into the sattvam. What is the highest sattvam? Hamsam. So, Hamsa Gita, after 15 slogas, he is going to start Hamsa Gita. Very beautifully, Krishna is going to recall and he says, I told you the Brahmam. I told you I am the Brahmam. Now I tell you how I did the Upadesham to Brahma as a Hamsam. Is going to talk. Very beautiful one. We'll see in the next chapter. We'll stop here. Kavidharke Kasimaya Kalyana Gunashaline Simade Venkatesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Simade Nihamanta Maha Deshikaya Namaha Adi Anadi.